فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
وكم من عائب. How many people have been blamed, have been scolded, have been rebuked? But in reality, their speech is correct. They've been blamed, but their speech and what they said was right. وَآفَتْهُ. The problem really is مِنَ فَهَمِ السَّقِيمِ, the deficiency in the one who's understanding it. How many people do we find who have been refuted, who are being blamed, who things have been said about them, but there's nothing wrong with what they said? The deficiency in the problem is the one who's trying to understand the word. He doesn't have no understanding. وَآفَتْهُ. The problem is مِنَ الْفَهْمِ السَّقِيمِ, the deficiency and the weakness in the one who tries to understand it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran that this Quran is clear. As he said in Surah Fussilat, ayah 44, وَلَوْ جَعَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا أَعْجَمِيًّا لَقَالُوا لَوْلَا فُصِّلَتْ آيَاتُ أَعْجَمِيٌّ وَعَرَبِيٌّ قُلْ هُوَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هُدًى وَشِفَاءٌ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ فِي آذَانِهِمْ وَقْرٌ وَهُوَ عَلَيْهِمْ عَمًى. Allah tells us, وَلَوْ جَعَلْنَاهُ, if we were to make it, قُرْآنًا أَعْجَمِيًا, a Qur'an that wasn't in the Arabic language, in another language, لَقَالُوا, they would have said, لَوْ لَا فُصِّلَتْ آيَاتُ, if only its verses were clarified and they were made clear. أَعْجَمِيٌ وَعَرَبِيٌ, a foreign language or an Arabic language. قُلْ, say to them, Muhammad, هُوَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هُدًى وَشِفَاءٌ. This Qur'an to the believers is a guidance, meaning as soon as they see the verse, it hits their heart and they love it. It's a cure for them. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ, as for the sick individuals who don't believe in Allah nor the Day of Judgment, فِي أَذَانِمْ وَقْرْ, their ears is something placed on it. وَهُوَ عَلَيْهِمْ عَمَنْ, and they are blind from it. This Qur'an, is nothing wrong with it. So look at it. A group of people are taking it in and they're accepting it and they're liking it and they're enjoying it. And for them it's a cure and an answer for their problems. And another group of people, all they see from it is deficiency, that the Qur'an is incomplete. The problem here is what? فِي أَذَانِهِ وَقْرًا. These people who are having this problem is nothing with the Qur'an. The problem is because their ears and their eyes, they are deaf, they are blind and they're dumb. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala sealed the hearts. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says in Surah An-Nisa ayah 82, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ, do they not ponder on the Qur'an? وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ, if this Qur'an was to come from anyone other than Allah. In other words, if somebody else was to say this Qur'an, if it was somebody else's speech, what would you have found? لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا, you would have found a lot of contradictions. If this Qur'an was to come from anybody other than Allah, you would have found a lot of contradiction. It goes against each other. But the reason why you don't find any contradiction is because it's from Allah. This Qur'an is from Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. وَلِذَلِكَ الْإِمَامُ الْغَزَالِيُ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ, الْإِمَامُ الْغَزَالِي, he was asked, and this statement, Al-Imam Zarkashi brings it in his kitab, Al-Burhan fi Ulum Al-Quran, that Imam Al-Ghazali was asked about this ayah, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقَفَالُهَا. No, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِي اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. What does it mean? And then he said, الْإِخْتِلَافُ لَفْظٌ مُشْتَرَكٌ بَيْنَ مَعَانٍ. He said the word اختلاف is a word that it's shared with many other words. It's a lafz which is mushtarak. It's a word that is shared by many other in meaning, in terms of meaning. Like the Arabs, the word ayn, eye, is actually the eye. The gold is called an eye. The place where the water springs from, huh, is called an eye. Had a lafz mushtarak. It's a lafz which is mushtarak. Many use it together. So here, the word ikhtilaf is like that. وَلَيْسَ الْمُرَادُ, the intent here is not نَفْيُ اخْتِلَافِ النَّاسِ فِيهِ. The ayah is when he's saying ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا. Is A, that you would have found differences and disagreements in the Quran, contradictions. This is not trying to say that the human beings are not going to differ upon the Quran. That's not what the ikhtilafiyah is, not talking about the subjective side of humans. In other words, yes, you guys may differ amongst yourselves on the Quran. That's not what the ayah is negating, he said. بَلْ نَفْيُ الْإِخْتِلَافِ عَنْ ذَاتِ الْقُرْآنِ. But what is negated is that the Qur'an, in its essence, does it have contradictions? Like, does the Qur'an have any, huh? لا. The Qur'an in and with itself is different. But na'am, we may have deficiency in our understanding. So here, my beloved brothers and sisters, is the differences is what? اختلاف ذات القرآن, the اختلاف within the Qur'an in and within itself. That's what the ayah is negating. As for the ikhtilaf that occurs from within the people, somebody reads an ayah, he takes something out of it. Another one comes, he takes something else out of it. هذا لا يعني, that doesn't mean that the ayah has done this. It is that these people, one of them lacks the tools to understand the ayah. And some scholars, they explain that those who have come with, the people who come with ikhtilaf on the Quran is for one of these reasons. And Imam al-Shatibi explains it. Ibn al-Qayyim explains it, Zarkashi in his Kitab al-Qur'an, they all mention it, Suyuti rahimahullah al-Itqan, they all mention it, which is what? It is either the person lacks the ability of understanding that this verse is abrogated, so there's no contradiction asalatan. There's no contradiction, it's abrogated. Or one of them is general and the other one is specific, and the specific takes precedence over the general. Or one of it is restricted and the other one is unrestricted, and the restricted takes precedence over the one that's not restricted. Or one of them is what? Ambiguous, and the other one is clear, and the clear one explains the ambiguous. Or the timing when the verse came down and the hukum it was speaking about is khas, or specific to the Prophet ﷺ, and no one else shares it with him. Or any other of those issues. The point is, those tools are missing from a person. So one is holding onto an ayah which is am, and the other one is holding onto an ayah which is khas. They both think that there's a contradiction between their statements. Or one is holding onto a verse that's abrogated and the other one is holding onto the one that abrogated. So here there's no contradiction, and the wajhul jam' is very simple. And Imam al-Shatibi rahimahullah, he also said a statement which of his that I think is very important, that I bring it to you all. If you go to the Kitab al-Muwafaqat by Imam al-Shatibi, which is the fifth volume, page 341, he says, and this statement of Shatibi actually goes a bit further. And you know what Imam al-Shatibi says? Imam al-Shatibi negates, not only does the Qur'an not have contradiction, rather evidences don't have contradiction, any evidences. The adilla to shar'iyya that are sahiha, correct. He said, every adilla sahiha, shar'iyya, they can't. Al-Kitab wa Sunnah wa Al-Ijma' and the Qiyas, which is Sahih. Are you with me? There's no contradiction. There's no contradiction, he says. He says the following: كل من تحقق بأصول الشريعة فأدلتها عنده لا تكاد تتعارض كما أن كل من حقق مناط المسائل فلا يكاد يقف في متشابه لأن الشريعة لا تعارض فيها البتة فالمتحقق بها متحقق بما في نفس الأمر فيلزم ألا يكون عنده تعارض ولذلك لا تجد البتة دليلين أجمع المسلمون على تعارضهما بحيث وجب عليهم الوقوف لكن لما كان أفراد المجتهدين غير معصومين من الخطأ أمكن التعارض بين الأدلة عندهم. الإمام الشاطبي says, anybody who reaches the reality of understanding the fundamental legislations. Kullu, everyone. Man tahaqqaqa, anybody who he reaches the reality, bi usul al-shari'ati, the fundamental legislation of the sharia, al-kitab wa sunnah wa al-ijma', and inshallah al-qiyas al-sahih. Fa'adillatuha, all those evidences of the sharia, indahu la tatakadu tata'arad. No contradiction in any way, form or shape, he won't find them. That's when he's, mashallah, he knows ja'am and the khas and the mutlaq and the muqayyid and the mujmal and the mubayyin and the nasq and the mansuq. He knows it all. كما, just like, أن كل من حقق مناط المسائل فلا يكاد يقف في متشابهين. And anybody who understands the manat, manat meaning the illah, the reasoning, anyone who comes to understand, من حقق مناط المسائل, he comes to understand the reasonings of a legislation, فلا يكاد يقف في متشابهين. That person will never stand on an ambiguous verse, آيات which are متشابه, he will never go with it. He will never go there. لأن الشريعة, because to him the شريعة لا تعارض فيها البتة, there is no contradictions in this شريعة at all. فالمتحقق بها متحقق بما في نفس الأمر. And the one who understood those as it is, then realizes the real, because now he's become close to the reality of the matter. In other words, the Quran, there's a perception a person can take from it. Your perception can be deficient. Like in and within itself, no. Once you've understood the Quran properly with its tools, you've now become emerged with the reality of the ayah and not your weak perception. فَيَلْزَمُ أَلَّا يَكُونَ عِنْدَهُ تَعَارُضٌ. So to this person, there is, it becomes unnecessary and it never occurs that there is contradiction with him. وَلِذَلِكَ لَا تَجِدُ أَلْبَتَّةَ دَلِيلَيْنِ. And this is the قاعدة he brings. And because of that, you're never going to find two evidences. This is قاعدة. قاعدة, one needs to memorize. ولذلك, and because of that, لا تجد, you will never find, البتتة, whatsoever, دليلين, two evidences, أجمع المسلمون, which the Muslims unanimously agree upon, على تعارضهما, you find a contradiction in it. Impossible. It is impossible. Two evidences, which the Muslims have unanimously agreed upon. The Muslims are all in agreement to this evidence. It's impossible for you to find contradiction in it. بحيث وجب عليهم الوقوف. It's contradicted itself to an extent where you have to withhold and say, I don't know. وقف. لا, you'll never find that. Now, what's the reason why we find some? لكن لما كان أفراد المجتهدين. But when individual scholars of اجتهاد who are غير معصومين and they are not infallible from mistakes, من الخطأ, from shortcomings, أم كان التعارض بين الأدلة عندهم. Then it became possible for contradiction to occur according to them. When they became, some scholars were mujtahideen, who fell into shortcoming. I mean, they were, how did they find it fall into shortcoming? Either they are sticking to an am, and they haven't seen the khas yet. So some evidence are contradicting themselves for them, due to the fact that they haven't seen this khas. Or this evidence for them, it is what? This evidence for them is, there's no evidence for them to abrogate it. So they haven't seen the abrogation of it. And they're holding on to it. So when a shortcoming came on their side, then it became possible for contradiction to come from the verse, or to seem to be there. Also, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he said, rahimahullah, in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, the 17th volume, page 394, he says, مَنْ سَأَلَ عَنْ مَعْنَى الْمُتَشَابِهِ لِيَعْرِفَهُ وَيُزِيلَ مَا عَرَضَهُ لَهُ مِنَ الشُّبَهِ وَعَالِمٍ مُلْمُحْكَمِ مُتَّبِعٌ لَهُ مُؤْمِنٌ بِالْمُتَشَابِهِ لَا يَقْصِدُ فِتْنَةً فَاذَا لَمْ يَذُمْهُ اللَّهُ. He has an issue that one needs to understand himself, understand for himself, which is some people may say, if I keep asking questions about آياتُ تَمُتَشَابِهِ, I'm scared that I'm going to fall into the ayah of هو الذي أنزل عليك الكتاب منه آيات محكمات هن أم الكتاب وأخر متشابهات فما الذين في قلوبهم زيغ فيتبعون ما تشابه. That I'm following ayat which are ambiguous. If I keep asking questions about these verses which are ambiguous, I'm worried and I'm concerned that I might fall into this verse, I might have a serious consequences the day of judgment, so how do I get out of this? But then this ayah seems to contradict itself to me. What shall I do? Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah responds and he says, if you're asking about this meaning of this verse, which is mutashabih, the reason why you're doing it is so you can know, you can lift yourself from ignorance, or to remove this doubt has come to you, and you are a person who is in belief and knows the muhkam. You love the muhkam, you know the verses need to be taken back to the muhkam, you appreciate that concept of the ambiguous verses, the unclear verses are taken back to the verses which are clear, and you're one who follows the muhkam whenever it's brought to you. You also Why else follow the muhkam? You believe in the mutashabih. Then the sheikh said, and you're not intending fitna from this. Then the sheikh said, this is not what the ayah is referring to. This is not what the ayah is referring to. And Imam Shatibi also said the same in his kitab, rahimahullah ta'ala, in his al-muwafaqat. Sorry, al-i'tisam. And Imam Shatibi says in al-i'tisam. Ala kulli hal, brothers, this issue of dealing of verses that seem to be going against each other, is it something new? Ayat which seem to contradict itself, that requires for it to be explained and for it to be clarified, is it something that just started recently? Or is it something that you would find in the kutubs of the tafsir and books? Is it something that sahabas would do? Now, the scholars of books of tafsir, if you read them and you look at them, you'll find it. And even if you look at the athar al-salaf al-salih, the pious predecessors from the sahabas and the students of the sahabas and the students of the students of the sahabas, you will find that they do respond to these issues. For instance, if you look at Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, Abdullah ibn Abbas, there was an individual who used to always come to him. And his name is Nafi' al-Azraq. Nafi' al-Azraq was a Khariji. And the group, the Azariqa, which is a firqa from the groups of the Khawarij, he was the one they attribute themselves to. He's their leader. And he used to come to Nafi' used to come to Abdullah ibn Abbas a lot, and would try to sometimes throw things at Ibn Abbas. And Ibn Abbas would respond to him and would give him answers. Also the same is Maqatib ibn Sulaiman al-Balkhi, who died in the year 115, as Imam Abu al-Hussein al-Maltiyu brought in his kitab al-Tanbih wal-Rad ala Ahli al-Ahwa'i wal-Bid'ah. Also the same with Muhammad ibn al-Mustanir al-Nahwiyu, who is well known for his name Biqutrubin, who died in 206 Hijriah. There's a book which is Al-Raddu ala al-Mulhideen fi tashabuhu al-Qur'an. Imam Ahmed, for example, who died in 241 Hijriah, rahimahullah ta'ala, he has a book called Al-Raddu ala al-Zanadiqati wal-Jahmiya, which he deals with verses which are ayatul sifat, which they distorted and they played around with. He brought them back, he took the doubts that they brought it, and he brought it to its correct tafsir and correct meaning. Ibn Qutaybah, مثلاً, he has a book called Ta'wil Mushkul al-Quran, the tafsir of verses of the Quran, doubts or the mushkilat that are in the Quran. Again, you find Abu al-Hussein al-Malti, al-Baqilani, he has a book called Al-Intisari al-Quran, Victory to the Quran. You will find also Al-Qadi Abdul Jabbar Al-Mu'tazili, who was married to Abul Hassan Al-Ash'ari's mom. He's his father-in-law. Abul Hassan Al-Ash'ari he left I'tizal, which was the first stage, because he went through three stages. As Imam Ibn Kathir mentions in his kitab Al-Bidayah wa Nihaya, and also Ibn Asakir mentions in his kitab Tabiyin Al-Kadhib Al-Muftara, that he, Al-Qadi Abdul Jabbar, was married to Imam Abul Hassan Ash'ari's mom. And so they debated about some issues, and he left him after he wasn't convinced with him. Na'am. Also, other scholars have written books in the issue of Imam Al-Izz ibn Abdul Salam. He has a book called Fawaid fi Mushkil al-Quran. في مشكل القرآن and others. There are many, many books that are written. So the efforts, the juhud, the efforts of the scholars in trying to combine and bring the verses together to show that these verses are not contradicting one another is excessive and large in number. But writing a particular book on just getting the ayah and how to reconcile the verses, ayah and to reconcile it, just specifically on this field like this, we have no book from it except this book written by Sheikh Muhammad Al-Amin Al-Shanqiti, which is Daf'ul Iham Al-Iddirab and Ayat Al-Kitab. There were books that were written before him, but they didn't reach us. They're mafqood. We don't have them. The one that we have today in our hands that has singled out this topic to deal with verses that seem to be contradicting one another, the first individual was Al-Imam Muhammad ibn al-Shaqiti. Some may say, you know, what about the kitab that you mentioned, which is Al-Raddu al-Mulhideen fi Tashabuh al-Qur'an? As I said to you, this book, as it's clear from its name, but it is mafqood, we don't have it. Also the kitab Durar al-Kalimat ala Wurar al-Ayat al-Muhimatu li-Ta'arud wa-Shubuhat. Both of them are mafqood. We don't have them. We don't have them. They're lost. Now, some books were said to be lost and then later in life were found. It happens. But for now, no one's seen it and no one's mentioned it anywhere. So it's in the world of the unseen. We don't know where it is. If Allah brings it, فَنِعِمَّهِ good it will be. But for now, this is the book we have by, written by Sheikh Muhammad Al-Amin Al-Shanqiti Rahimahullah. After Sheikh Muhammad Al-Amin Al-Shanqiti, then everybody took their pen and paper, and every single, or a lot of scholars, they tried to write books on it. And there are more than 30 Rasail Jami'iyya from them. Bayanu fi daf'i ta'arud al-mutawahama bayna ayat al-Qur'an, written by Muhammad Abu Nur al-Hadidi. Da'awa al-tanaqud bayna nusus al-Qur'an al-Karim, تاريخها ومعالجتها وسآيات العقيدة التي قد يوهم ظاهرها التعارض موهم الاختلاف والتناقض في القرآن وآراء العلماء فيه موهم الاختلاف والتناقض في القرآن نظر رسالة ماجستير دعاوى الطاعنين في القرآن الكريم في القرن الرابع عشرة الهجري والرد عليها دفع التعارض المتوهم بين آيات القرآن الكريم في العقيدة دراسة تفسيرية تحليلية. Scholars they went and they wrote a lot of books on it. There's a point that I need to mention before we go into the Risala, now that we have an understanding of it, which is Sheikh Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqiti, there are some things he left out. I remember the issue of ta'arud is subjective. Something you might see as to be ta'arud, another person say, well, that's crystal clear. And another person, so because it's subjective, sometimes you find he would even mention things that you would think to yourself, where's the ta'arud here? Right, for me, this was crystal clear. I have no problem with this. But he wrote it, rahimahullah, because there was, and he saw some people who had that doubt. Inshallah ta'ala, when I mention where he based his book on, the Shaykh rahimahullah ta'ala, he based his book on three things when he wrote it. The Shaykh based it on questions and doubts that were put in before. Scholars have brought it before him, and he saw it from books. As we're going to see later, he brought some of the doubts that were written in the kitab Al-Raddu al-Jahmiyyat wa Zanadiqa by Imam Ahmed, and he brings answers from it. So these were things that were there before him, so he brings those. So that's one type. The second one are issues that the Shaykh saw that scholars have put forward. The scholars, they put it forward from the angle of mubahata research. You know, they just i'tirad by themselves. They just bring the point up and then they respond to it in their own books. When they're researching an issue or tackling an issue or saying, you know, in a tafsir lesson, like, don't confuse it with this ayah, for instance. The Shaykh wrote that as a ta'aruf. Or the third one, which is he himself, rahimahullah, things that he saw that could be taken as a ta'aruf. Ayat which he thought himself that these ayat, it could be ayat that could be taken as a ta'aruf and a contradiction can come from it. And he mentions that, rahimahullah ta'ala, in his Adhb al-Namir. He mentions that in his Adhb al-Namir, he says, إِنَّ مِنْ عَادَاتِنَا from our norms is الَّتِي نَجْرِي عَلَيْهَا فِي هَذِي الدُّرُوسِ from our norms and the things that we're going to be doing in these lessons is أن نتعرض لما نظن أنه يسأل عنه طلبة العلم. To present ourselves to or to deal with things that we may think that the students will ask. So we'll try to precede you in it. The Shaykh will do that. رحمه الله. So those are the three. عليه رحمة الله. He himself, as I said before, he left and he missed out some things. And I said the point of missing out is subjective. Some of them, his student, Sheikh Atiyah Salim, brings it. Sheikh Atiyah Salim brings it. he mentions some things. And as I said to you before, Sheikh al-Islam Taymiyyah says, قد يشكل على هذا ما يعرفه هذا. Sometimes something may become ambiguous and unclear to you, but it might become, it's well known to him, and he's well aware of it. So the ishkal that may occur for you may not occur for somebody. So again, it's subjective. It's subjective. But there are some things that Atiyah Salim, who's the student of Sheikh Muhammad Ibn Shaqidi, put forward himself. Many places. When he's Adwa'ul, because he has a tatimma on Adwa'ul Bayan, as I said, he carried on Adwa'ul Bayan. For example, the word Abasa wa Tawalla. You see, Anja'ahu al-A'ma. This ayah, when Abasa wa Tawalla, he came and the Prophet Abasa, where he faced the scroll to alayhi sallam. There could seem a contradiction with the ayah, wa innaka ala khuluqin azim. You're of high caliber and high characteristics. But then the Prophet scrolled his face. Shaykh Muhammad Amin Shaqidi didn't speak about this in his kitab that we're going to see inshaAllah ta'ala. So he goes and speaks about it, and he says in this, وَلَمْ أَقِفْ عَلَى جَوَابٍ لِذَٰلِكَ. I have not found an answer from our Shaykh Muhammad Amin Shaqidi regarding this. وَلَمْ يَتَعَرَّضَ لَهُ الشَّيْخ. And he said the Shaykh didn't go towards this. رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى عَلَيْنَا. رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْنَا وَعَلَيْهِ. May Allah have mercy upon him and us. في دفع إيهام الاضطراب. In his book, إيهام الاضطراب. وَالَّذِي يَظْهَرُ. What it seems to be apparent to me, Atiyah Salim, is, and Allah knows best, is أنه لا يتأتى معه لأنه لم يتكلم بما يسيء إلى هذا الصحابي في نفسه بشيء يسمعه فيزعجه. Since this Sahabi was blind, the Prophet had no bad manners with him because he couldn't see this. He could not have seen it. So the Prophet ﷺ did not deal with him in anything that is bad manners because he doesn't know what happened. Does that make sense? Huh? Bad manners is you deal with a person in that which they are capable of feeling from you or they get from you. And there are other things that he mentions, Muhammad Atiyah Salim. Now what we need to understand is he himself, Muhammad Ibn Shanqiti, brings in his own Adwa'ul Bayan some things that ayat which are dhahiruhu ta'aruf. He mentions it, but he never mentioned in Daf'ul Iham. He doesn't mention in his Daf'ul Iham in al-Dirab fi ayati al-kitab, but he mentions it in his Adwa'ul Bayan. So one can do is that he can get those and maybe make it bigger. Maybe make it bigger and do another daba'ah on it. The last point that I'm going to conclude with this introduction, inshallah ta'ala, is the Shaykh rahimahullah, in this book of his, he organized the Quran according to how it is. He put it in the sequence. Surah Al-Fatiha, Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Ali Imran, Surah Al-Nisa, and he went on like that. Every surah, he brought what contradiction that may seem in that verse, in that surah, he brought it. Alayhi rahmatullah. The verses, Surah Al-Baqarah, when he finishes it, he goes to Al-Imran after that. And then he goes to An-Nisa, and he goes on like that. There are 12 surahs he never brought. 12 surahs the Shaykh didn't bring. Surah Al-Fatiha, Surah Al-Sharh, Surah Al-Sharh, Surah Al-Bayyina, Surah Al-Takathur, سورة الهمزة سورة الفيل سورة قريش الكوثر النصر المسد الإخلاص الفلق. And the overall matters or the overall مسائل that the Shaykh dealt with, if you count it, is 242 is what he dealt with رحمه الله تعالى of إشكالات and topics. He explained, alayhi rahmatullah, may Allah have mercy upon him. Without any further ado, inshallah ta'ala, we will be idhnillahi al-kareem. We will start the book, bi idhnillahi al-kareem.